Hello and welcome to my 6 weeks postpartum update and 6 weeks old update for this little munchkin. Say hi to everybody, Nora. Do you have a smile for us? Oh, she's checking things out. She's very alert. She's growing so big. She's in a 3 month onesie. She's out of newborn diapers, out of newborn clothes. It's kind of sad, but also feel so proud that she's growing and growing fast. We just had our 6 week checkup and everything's looking good. So thankful to have had the last 6 weeks with her, and I can't imagine our life without her. Now she is just so precious and a sweet natured baby. She was weighed and she was 10 pounds and 12 ounces. Getting so big, growing out of all the newborn inserts of things too, and officially an infant and out of the initial 6 weeks of the newborn stage. And there's a cute baby on. We just stare at her all the time and caption her faces, wonder what she's thinking, and it really is the best. We've had an awesome time with her, and this past week's been a little crazy. We had tornado warnings one night and we're up in the middle of the night, and thankfully we are safe and praying for everyone who's been affected by those crazy record-breaking storms. We scooped up our kids and went downstairs, camped out for an hour, and it blew over, thankfully. But life is so different with three kids. We are outnumbered. Me and my husband have to work together and juggle these three kids. But he has been awesome and so helpful and supportive. My friends and family have really come through with meals and coming over to help and washing dishes or holding the baby or playing with the big kids so I can do what I need to do. And this week we were up late several nights in a row, and I was also starting back singing at church and getting back to work. So I have a lot of new things going on, new transitions, new routines, and so just figuring things out as we go and figure out what needs to happen. And so a few days ago, I was really tired. I had lost a lot of sleep. And then I had one night with night sweats and chills, and I ended up dealing with mastitis. And it was, I guess, a mild case. It lasted about a day, and I did what I could to manage that, and thankfully I'm feeling better now. But I did whatever I could. You know, I Google things if I don't know the answer. I remember some things because I have dealt with it before, but it's not fun, and I felt pretty awful the other day. But we just took it easy. I got some rest, and I was able to get over that in a day or so. And so pretty much back to normal, or whatever this new normal is. We're still figuring that out. And as soon as you get into like a routine, or when you're expecting things to go a certain way, it changes. And that's just life with kids. But look how cute she is. She's worth it. She's worth it. Several people have asked me in the last week or so if she's sleeping well, if I'm getting any sleep. And there were those crazy few nights, but for the most part, she's just been waking up like two or three times at night to eat every 3 hours or so, and then goes back to sleep. So she's been a great sleeper, good eater. She's growing, obviously, which is awesome. And so she's just a champ. She's eating, sleeping, pooping on repeat, doing all the baby things. She thinks it's funny. She's smiling every time I talk about pooping. She's like, yeah, I'm a good pooper. She is proud of that. She'll make a diaper and then just smile so big, like, I'm so relieved. And so that's just the baby bubble that we are living in. And it's been awesome. I wanted to just kind of share an update for those that have followed along on our journey and waiting for this sweet baby to come, and just to know that she's so worth the wait. We have loved getting to know her as far as we can tell, you know, from these facial expressions. Oh my goodness, look at those eyebrows. See, we're just in love. Like, this is what we do. We stare at the baby and take care of the baby and juggle kids. When I had my 6 week checkup with the midwife, thankfully everything physically is good. I've been healing well. She asked me, how am I doing emotionally? And this has actually been the smoothest recovery of my three births. And emotionally, I was telling her that I have moments of overwhelm, especially when two out of the three kids are crying, or all three kids are crying, or we're all crying. There are definitely moments where I feel overwhelmed and I'm like, this is a lot. There is a lot going on and I don't even know where to start. And so I have had to coach myself out of that and just take one thing at a time, get everybody outside, change the scenery, do something to start calming people down. And we've had to learn a new family dynamic of we have to take turns and it's not all about you, toddler. And so it takes all of us. And for the most part, the big kids are doing really well, like helping with her and wanting to kiss the baby and talk to her and calm her down if she's crying. But I have, you know, felt moments of overwhelm, but not felt overwhelmed all day, every day, crying every day. It has not been, you know, super emotional. I've just had like highs and lows, highs and lows, highs and lows, as my hormones are still not back to normal. They still have lows, and like I mentioned, like experiencing night sweats and things like that are because of the hormones still adjusting and balancing out. I thought I almost made it out of the 6 weeks without any chills. I remember having chills before and night sweats, but it was like the day before my checkup that I had chills, and I was like, man, I almost made it out without that. But it's just part of it. Like sometimes you have really random symptoms and things, and that was connected to the mastitis, to have sweats and chills at the same time, and pretty miserable, but thankfully did not last very long. And so we are just figuring things out at this point. At 6 weeks postpartum, nothing fits. Like my clothes are still stretchy. I'm not really sure what size I am. I'm between maternity clothes, which are too loose and just do not fit, and then my regular clothes, which I have a variety of sizes from being pregnant before, being postpartum before, going from a range of like medium, large, extra large, somewhere in there. So I have some clothes, but they're in different seasons and some of them don't fit anymore. So I'm trying to figure out like what I can fit in every single day. I'm like, okay, what's gonna fit today? And I'm in between maternity clothes, which do not fit, and my regular clothes, which do not fit. So it's just kind of a twilight zone right now of what's gonna fit. And I did order a few things to help me kind of bridge that gap. And as I'm going back to singing and being in front of people, and you know, I don't want to be just wearing sweatpants all the time, I decided I need some regular clothes that fit me. So that's an encouragement for anyone if you're in the postpartum phase and you're trying to figure out, you know, what's going to fit. Just buy a few things that are the size that you are now. I stepped on the scale for the 6 week checkup and I stepped back off and I was like, I'm pretty sure this isn't calibrated. Let's double check. I had my husband stand on it and I was like, is that how much you weigh? And he's like, yeah, that's pretty normal. I was like, man. So I stepped on it again and I was like, I don't believe it. I don't believe that number. Like I hadn't stepped on the scale in weeks, so I didn't know how much I weighed, but it wasn't that much less. And so I was like, surely I've lost more than that. Like she's gaining and she's like 10 pounds. So surely at least there's the 10 pounds of this baby that's gone, right? So, I mean, I just kind of laughed at that. And I told my midwife, just put it down, write down whatever's on the scale, because I know it's going to change. It's going to change every day. It's going to change every week. It's going to be, you know, a few months to get back to like a normal weight, and not even pre-pregnancy. I don't want to get that low again. I was my lowest weight and it was scary because I kept losing weight and couldn't stop losing weight. It was unhealthy. And so that's when I really, you know, boosted my nutrition and was taking better care of myself and was able to get to a healthy weight. And that's what I want to go back to, is the healthy weight, not my low pre-pregnancy weight, but like a healthy, strong, you know, taking care of myself and taking care of my babies. That is priority. That is the goal. And so that's where we're living right now. Oh, you want to say something? She's straightening out her legs, so I'm trying to let her stand up a little bit, get some independence. Do you want to say something? Everybody loves you. Oh, he's probably hungry, so we're gonna go take care of that. But I wanted to give you a quick update on how things are going, and thank you for following along. Feel free to leave any questions you have in the comments about postpartum. And for any mamas out there, hang in there, you're doing a good job. These babies are so worth it. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in our next video. Bye.